Hello my friends, Tuplay here, and I just decided today to test the VirtualMan Pi4 emuls booting directly from USB on my Pi3B. I don't have a B+, so we're just testing a normal USB direct boot from my USB Orico case, including an Extreme Pro SanDisk, 960 gigs. Alright, so it booted up fine, and we have the Tron theme. And actually, I just wanted to share with you that I tested by changing in the CMD line the TTY to number 3. So the terminal used to boot was 3 instead of 1 being used on a Pi4. So it boots fine, splash screens are okay, and what I wanted to see, because a lot of people asking again and still asking about if we boot the image on Pi3. Yes, it will boot on Pi3. The question, as I mentioned in the initial video, is how many of the emulators or cores will run on Pi3 since it was initially compiled on a Pi4. I know, I think for certain that, because I tested in the past, that AmiBerry binary won't start, but since we're just all here and I'm gonna go through every single emulator and or system that is installed on VirtualMan Pi4 image, and I'm gonna test on my Pi3 which ones they run fine as is. I'm gonna replace the ones that they don't run, the binary or the core, from my PlayBox version 2 Pi3 setup, and see if that will fix it so it can boot and play all the games as is. What I'm going to try, I'm going to test only one game per system because I don't want to make this video very long, and I'm going to go to the CLI and see if we start the desktop, if the desktop will go fine without calling the emulation station and freeze it. So let's see. I'm gonna press F4. We're going to the command line, and we have, as you can see, the CPU max is 1200, which is my 3B. As I said, we have 881 gigs of the rootfs max partition, 448 used and 397 free, 54%, because it was expanded before on the Pi4 custom Raspi config we did, and the temperature that we can see is 51 degrees Celsius or 123 for both CPU and GPU, and we have 272 free of RAM and 629 total. It's using 256 because that's 1 gigabyte RAM model, the one I have on Pi3, so it automatically uses 256 gigs for the GPU and the rest are for the system. So let's try to start X and see if the desktop will start fine without calling the emulation station or freeze up. I'm waiting. I see activity on the USB. And it seems it went to call the emulation station as we had the same thing on Pi4, and I'm going to change the terminal with Control Alt and F1, F2, there we are. So I'm going to call login Pi, and then I'm going to put the playbox password. All right, so I'm going to use htop command, and I'm going to scroll all the way down and find this line that says opt RetroPie supplementary emulation station emulation station.asm, and I'm going to kill that. So I'm going to press F9 and enter, and all the emulation station running got killed. So I'm going to press F10 to quit, and I'm going to go back to the terminal 3. I'm going to go to 1, and yeah, it's a 1, so the terminal 1 has the desktop. So you can see it's working fine. It was just because the emulation station started cold while the desktop was running. This is something to be fixed. So I'm going to go sat down, and I'm going to go exit to command line, and we're going to call the emulation station again and go back in. So I'm going to test, as I said, everything known to Pi4 and see how it's working, the buster with KMS, and the latest message drivers we have for the eDream, if they're working okay. So this setup, as we said, it has KMS enabled, it has buster, and so far it's running on a Pi3 as intended to do. But the problem is, and something to be seen, is how many of these running. So let's start kodi. Since running, it's 18.5. So my friend VMan, yeah, the keyboard is working okay. So I'm gonna go to exit. So we have kodi running fine. And we're back in ES. So we're gonna go to, let's start with Amiga. So I'm gonna start just, and then let's go to Agony that you've seen in the last one too, last video. So we have the loading screen. And the binary on this image is the Pi4 binary with KMS, and it seems to be working fine too. The sound is okay, and I'm happy to see that, because in my initial test, this AmiBerry wouldn't run. So let's see the version. F12, and we'll go about, and we'll have 3.1.2. They're all good. And let's exit. Just happy to see this. Quit. Okay, because I know you like, I'm just gonna try another one, Alien 3. Another thing about this press A button, I'm going to check if the command line okay, it seems running. So let's press okay, F12. Let's go and change the input to keyboard and see if this kind of fix, and let me continue. Yeah, the keyboard seems to be working. Okay. So the game is running fine too, so let's go out. I don't want to waste your time. Quit. And let's go to another system. So let's go to Amiga CD32. This one should run fine because it's Amiberry again. Okay, the hidden interface of WH3 load seems okay. And the game seems to be starting. Yep, all good. So F12 and let's exit. So next one. We go to Amstrad CPC and let's start Barbarian. Yep, the core seems to be working okay. Let's press 1. And it's working fine. So I'm going to press my F5 and 6, which I assigned as select and start, so to exit. The retroarch, and another OK, so let's go to Arcade Classics. I see some glitches on the themes. It's probably due to the graphics or maybe it's too heavy for the 1200 hertz of the Raspberry Pi 3. It's not overclocked. So let's test 1000 milia or 1000 miles. Yep, starting up. I'm gonna insert a coin. Yep, and it's working fine. It's a RetroArch core from what I see. Yes, keys are working okay. All good gents. So, exit. Next one. Let's change to maybe a lighter theme, if possible. Let's go to UI. Let's go here and let's see. binary for the Pi3. Yep, it's running fine, guys. So let's exit. So let's go to Atari 5200. There seems to be more glitches now. I want to see, I'm going to test this later and tell you like if we update just the ES, if this is going to be fixed or not. Yep, it's working fine too. So 5200 is working, Atari 7800. So let's try this one. Yes, there's a lot of artifacts. So I don't know if that would be because, yeah, this is running too. So let's exit. Due to so it's not the binary, it's not, it might be the KMS driver affecting it or the Pi3 low CPU speed. So let's go escape, let's go to links, let's start the first one. About this visual glitches, everything seems to be working fine and okay. So there we are, press enter, start, okay, yep, it's working fine, guys. So escape, fire, and let's go exit. All right, so let's go to, now we have Atomic Wave. Let's see. Let's start which one. King of Fighters, Rumble Fish. I'll try the Rumble Fish. So let's continue to see that, see that systems. Let's see Alicat, Commodore 64, and I'm gonna press, that was a little bit slow, I wanna check the run command if it's working. Alright, C64 seems to be running. So let's see if it's gonna start up. So that's the C64. I believe a LR Vice core. Yep, and it's running fine. Let's go back. I believe all the cores would run fine. So let's go to ColecoVision and let's start Alcazar. Yep, that's another one. Dead. So we go out. All right, so that's another core. Let's go to Daphne. And let's start Cliffhanger. Okay, we see the test image. Please stand by, and cliffhanger seems to be running. So, just pressing enter.
Cliffhanger, a game that keeps you on.
Press escape and we're going out. Alright, so let's see Dreamcast. So as far as I know, this one should run with Redream. Let's see if it will run or not. Yes, it will run. So Dreamcast is out of the question. Family, Famicom. Yep, it's working okay. Let's exit. So let's go to FDS. Should run fine too. Yes. Super Famicom. Let's see some gameplay. Yeah, it's working. So let's exit. Okay, game and watch. So we have, should be fine too. There's another core. Yep, so let's so again here. Yes. Game Boy. Yes. So Game Boy Advance. Should be fine too. Seems like everything that uses a core apart the flycast is working okay. Sega Genesis. Yeah. Intellivision. Okay, the core is running okay. Sega Master System. MSX. Nintendo 64, I don't think it's gonna run okay. Let's start it up. Okay, so this one did run. I don't know if it is the default driver, the emulator. Let's see in the configs. Okay, the default in the configs is alarm open 64 plus next. This one is not running. Unless there's something else applied. N64. Let's exit. Now maybe it's not gonna run. NDS. Okay, so let's continue. Neo Geo. That should be the FB Neo Core, so probably should start fine. Looks like it. Yes. So let's go. New GCD, that would be the LR Neo Geo CD core. Yes, is the LR Neo CD core. Working fine as it seems. Yep, all good. So let's go exit. So new Geo Pocket Color. Yep, that looks good too. So NES. Yep. So super yes. Okay, next. Now let's see the MVU. Or in other words, it's an SCD. It's running, yeah, it should be the same. The cores are very specific for these systems. Let's exit. Now let's see, open more. Yep, looks fine. I'm gonna quit and I wanna see a game actually that was a problem, I think. Okay, it fades. And then security PSP number 3, so let's see. This one I expect to be the same, probably kind of heavy. Alright, so PSP is not running. Let's see the minis. And let me see, because I think the PSP probably has the actual standalone emulator. So PSP, when my friend VirtualMan has enabled. Yes, it's the standalone PPSP. So that might be due to being compiled for Pi4, that's why it's not running. But this one, it should be probably the... Yes, that's the core. So let's exit. And I'm gonna see if I can run the PTSP. So the PSP with the core enabled. So I'm gonna change in the config from the standalone to the core, and let's try one more time to run the 300 march glory. Okay. Let's exit and now PS6. Looking fine as it seems. And this one uses the LRPCX rearmed core. It's pretty smooth, so let's exit. All right, let's check scan VM. running fine as it seems. It's using the LR scum VM. That's why you see the bezel 2. Enter. Yeah, the keyboard arrow moves the arrows fine. Enter, make a point. Okay, so let's press start select. So Genesis 32. Let's check. Afterburner. Should run fine, I guess. Yep. Another core based system. So let's exit. Sega CD. Looks fine. All right, so let's exit. Sega is 1000. Let's move on. TurboGrafx 16, 1941. Yes, it's fine. It's sad that we got a delay for these nice little mini consoles. I expected to be in March out, but due to the COVID-19 we have delays. Actually, I was looking for the core graphics. And let's check TurboGrafx CD or PC engine CD, same thing. Looks fine. So, next one. So, TI-99. Let's test. Let's do the antiquer. Some of these loading screens are really nice. Now, press any key to begin. 2 for anteater, 2 on the keyboard, and select initial game level 1 to 9. Let's try one game. Level 1. I'm using just the mouse is working fine. Okay, so see, the point is to get the sugar cane or whatever. Okay, take it back home. The first time I'm playing this game. I like it. It reminds kind of Big Dog. It's kind of fun. I guess these boulders can be used to kill the anteater. Straight home. There you are. Okay. So let's exit. Escape. So that's a stand alone emulator. So let's go to Vectrex. That should be a core based one. There was an error on the top. The game started. So rotate left, right, thirst, and fire. So if I press start, player two, game one. Okay. Player one. All right, and let's start. Right and left. Right. Anyway, it's running. So next. Virtual Boy. Looks fine. Nice, interesting bezel. It's fine. It's working. So next one, SARP X68000. Let's check this one. Okay, another core based. As I said, this one could get better alignment. So let's go up and enter. And now for this one, I think we have to wait a little bit. Some music. That's great. It's running. Just need a little bit of patience. Yeah, it's working fine. So let's exit. Next spectrum. Let's try maybe this one. I remember this one had this on a tape. Let's see. Capstone joystick, nope. Yes, I remember this. Drawing the backgrounds and everything. Let's go update the script. Manage core packages.
All right, guys, in the final steps, just finish up. You can remove and reinstall it from binary, then connect your SFTP client. I prefer WinCP or FlashFXP. Use the if you're using the pre-done packages that I have created for you from Discord, then use the SU connection. And then drop the binaries to override the ones existing in the path of opt/retropie/emulators. And some of them that might be in a subfolder called bin. And then the any cores that go in the libretro cores folder. And you're going to see a subfolder with the name of that core. And you just drop it there. It will automatically override and keep all the permissions and stuff. So that's it, guys. Thank you again for watching and sorry for the long video.